Almost down. fries?
They're often
much for their horns. Some think that their horns serve a medicinal purpose. Those horns are just made out of keratin. It's the same thing that your fingernails are made out of. Nothing too special there. That's why it's really important that we do our best to help take care of those rhinos. Towards the water. A lot of times they're hard to find because they spend most of their days below the surface and they don't need to come up for air all too often.
What?
Yeah, a bunch of those blackbirds. Those are just local black vultures. Definitely not from Africa. African vultures are much, much bigger. They're a little hard to see, but yeah, on the left you can see there are some hippos poking out of the water just a tiny bit.
Oh,
looks like they are just sleeping right now.
Way over there behind.
Hippos are nocturnal animals, so if you sleep a good chunk of the day, let's see if we can get another view of some more.
Look back on the left, you can see them hanging out. See a few of them here. Those horns can grow to be up to 6 feet long from end to end. They look really heavy, but those horns are mostly hollow. They're actually pretty lightweight on top of their heads. Some parts of the world are called the Watusi.
How do they keep them in there?
They're more often seen as a status symbol for how many you own, not used for their meat all that often.
They can walk wherever they want out here.
Now,
they can come right up here if they want.
I want to see the cheetah.
I don't think they do.
see who we can find over here on the left. Now there is a den up there. That den belongs to some African wild dogs. I'm not seeing any yet. Well, we'll see if they're hanging around in the back there. They usually hang out in packs of about 5 to 15 dogs. So if there are some, we should see a few. Yeah, if you look to your left, there's a few of those dogs. They're all just kind of laying in a pile in the back behind the den there.
Yeah, I see them. They're way back
there. Yeah, not active at all right now. Looks like they're just sleeping. Oh, one's peeking up a little bit there. So those are called African wild dogs. Actually, some of the most successful hunters in all of Africa. This is over 90% of their dogs. And now I see a few more animals coming up over here. Oh, wow. Got quite a few in this back corner here. So of course we have some zebras there. In the very back I see a Patterson Spitland. I can see the brown antelope with the big curved horns. These are sable antelope. Next to us there's a whole bunch of these wildebeest. And then of course we have some of our Maasai drive there. Getting some food from that tree. See a few more of these giraffes coming up. They are the tallest land animals in the world, usually standing around 14 to 18 feet tall. Giraffes spend most of their days just eating food. They usually spend about 16 to 20 hours a day just eating, so it's pretty much all they do. Oh, look over on the left and see our baby giraffe walking around. Yeah, the baby over there is about 7 months old, still very young. Zebras there. I see a few more wildebeests on the right, and there's also this little brown antelope called the springbok. Things like the springbok are all just laying out in a circle right now. They are incredibly fast. Looks like this side of the savanna is a little quiet right now. Animals do tend to migrate around as the day goes on. Looks like they just kind of migrate out of this area. Keep on moving forward. Next, we're going to be heading through elephant country, so let's see if we can get a good look at some elephants coming up. Get a better look at them in just a bit, but you can actually see them around those bushes on the right there. It's one of our African elephants. It's a little far back, as I said, we'll try to get a better look in just a bit. Ooh, first here, look to your left. So all the way up on top of that rock in the middle, you'll see a mandrill. It's our largest mandrill. There's a few more hanging out in these trees down here as well. That's our mandrill monkeys.
Oh, that's it.
I
see if we can find any other elephants from this angle or get another view of that one that we saw a little bit earlier.
Oh, it looks like there's two, but yeah, again, there's kind of a tough spot to see, but yeah, you can see those two hanging out over there. And we're going to keep on moving forward in just a bit. We're going to try to get a better look at some more up ahead. We can guess that those two over there are probably male elephants tend to go off in groups, like small groups like that one. Sure. The female elephants, on the other hand, they stick in. Are almost kind of shaped like the continent of Africa, so it makes it pretty easy to remember. So you'll see them fan those huge ears back and forth, and they'll have to cool their bodies down. They can cool themselves down by up to 15 degrees just by fanning their ears like that. Looks like they're mostly hanging out and eating food. They are the largest land animals in the world, so they do need to eat quite a lot to maintain their size.
Cheetah or a lion will not attack someone from you.
No, I think I
see one more laying out in the back corner. Oh, two more back there.
Oh yeah, look, they're fucking
so fresh.
They're really looking.
Looks like they're just getting some rest. They are the fastest land animals in the world, though. They can run up to 65 miles per hour. They can reach those speeds in just 3 seconds. There are more structures, though, so they can't hold that speed too long. They would really do see somebody. Oh wow, lots going on up here. So, walking up the road ahead of us, I did see an ostrich. We'll see if we just follow behind her for a little bit. There she go. Oh, she's running. She's gone.
Alright. Well, look to your left here.
Oh, yeah, on top of that rock. Beautiful look at our lioness up there. And then actually down there in the grassy area, there's another lioness with their head poking up there.
Look right there. There's a bone.
The lions really like to go up on these big kopi rocks. It's a good spot for them to get some sun. It's also a good spot this evening. Good spot to pray or any friends in the area.
Three ostriches.
Here we'll get a little bit better. We'll look at some of those ostriches on the right there.
Those
ostriches are the largest
birds. No, ostriches are faster than lions. Come on,
we'll be right there. We'll catch up with them again in just a bit.
I'm riding these down.
Spent most of their days sleeping, but it looks like she's somewhat awake right now. I'm looking to see them. Always good to see them climb all the way up on top of that rock. Now we see another animal coming up, so look to your left here. Over by these trees, there's some warthogs hanging out in the middle of them.
Warthogs.
You can see those big holes there as well. Those are my warthog burrows.
These are the largest birds in the world. They can run up to 40 miles per hour. It makes them the fastest land animals on 2 feet in the world. Now look to the right here, you'll see those huge eggs right by the truck.
Yeah, it's an ostrich.
That's by the size of that eggs are on your pig. Each one weighing about 3 pounds. The equivalent of about 2 dozen chicken eggs.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, we're gonna... That's funny.
Thank you. Bienvenido nuevamente, mis amigos. Permanezcan sentados con los cinturones de seguridad apretados y sus manos dentro de la bolsa. Un guía les dirá cuándo puede subir. Por favor, salgan con cuidado.
Okay, thank you.
Right? On the drink?
Did you bring me one of the drinks?
Lots of that's exciting.
He might put missing
no
clue
where we're going that way. Right.
Why is that
in the
here now.
No, eso no hay nada.
Bueno, esperamos.
Sister has a
hello.
I'm Dr. Marsh, director of the Dino Institute, and I hope you enjoyed those quaint exhibits in the old wing. That's how dinosaurs have been presented to the public since the study of fossils began over 150 years ago. Today, that bare bones approach is about to become extinct. In a perfect blending of science and technology, the Dino Institute has created the Time Rover, an amazing vehicle that will literally transport you to the age of the dinosaurs. How? That's proprietary. But the result is a breathtaking journey through a prehistoric world where you'll witness the most spectacular creatures to ever walk the earth. In a moment, you'll be going live to our control center for a comprehensive safety briefing. And then it's on to the tour that will convince you forever that the future is truly in the past.
Hello there. Welcome to our little trans-dimensional joyride, folks. I'm Dr. Seeker, your friendly controller and a heck of a paleontologist, if I do say so myself. But let's not talk about me, let's talk about you and how you can help me make history today with the Time Rover. It's like this. If I can bring you back from the Cretaceous period, it stands to reason that I can bring back a live dinosaur with you, and not just any dinosaur. Take a look at this guy. He's an iguanodon, and I'm certain that he is the key to understanding these magnificent creatures.
I tagged him with a locator during an unauthorized field trip. Otherwise, I'd be traveling with you. Right now, our dino should be about here, at the very end of the Cretaceous period. That's where you're going today.
I arrived, it seems, just in time to correct a little misstatement.
Dr. Marsh.
That is impossibly close to the giant asteroid impact that destroyed most life forms on Earth. Our tours are designed to take you to the early Cretaceous period, and I can assure you that all Time Rovers have been securely locked on those coordinates.
That's right. See?
Securely locked. Access denied.
Continue.
Of course. We were just talking about seatbelts. Plug them in, use them. It can get kind of choppy out there, so keep your hands and arms inside the vehicle at all times.
Flash photography? I wouldn't. It alters the homing signal, and that's not good. Oh, and one more thing. Those locked coordinates? We're in. Now, here's the drill. You follow the homing signal to the iguanodon, then I'll enlarge the transport field, and boom, you're back with one additional passenger extra large. And don't worry about that asteroid. You'll be in and out of there before it even breaks the atmosphere. Trust me, what could go wrong?
Iguanodon and get out before the asteroid hits. Let's roll!
Let's go get that dino. Computer, what are you tracking?
It's Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
Polyoramus. Hadrosaur. Raptor.
Time to get serious. Lock the auto pilot signal now! Hang on! I'm tracking the big dino on the scope. Could be ours. Computer, full stop. Identify.
Carnotaurus.
Definitely not our dino. Go, go, go! Another big guy coming up. Computer. And identify.
Sauropod.
Still not our dino, but at least this one's a vegetarian.
Asteroid impact in 90 seconds.
We better move it.
Pterodactyl.
Incoming!
Asteroid impact in 60 seconds.
We can't stop now! Keep going, keep going!
Compsognathus.
Computer, what's happening?
Loss of traction.
More Now what?
Carnotaurus.
That's it! Abort mission! Abort! Abort!
Iguanodon.
Forget it! Get them out now!
It is a really good spot. Right?
Oh, you're hiding!
You remember that one in the aquarium that you could never figure out if it was alive or dead?
Thank you. it's more like the 49th
one. Put your wings together for the host of our show, everyone's favorite ant, Flick!
Fireflies! Fireflies! Up here! Over here! Way over! Way over! A little more! A little more! A little less!
Perfect.
Oh, and hi, hello, and welcome. Welcome to our show. You know, we've been doing this act for over 300 million years. And with bugs making up more than 80% of the animal world, we're the biggest cast of them all. Still, you guys just don't seem to see us. So, that's why we gave you those special bug eyes. Go ahead, put them on. Neat, huh? Yeah, no. Now you're all honorary bugs, so, on with the show! Okay, thanks, little pal. You're done now.
Huh?
What? My dad. Off to the moon. Yeah, thank you.
Oh.
Take it from an ant. It's tough to be a bug. That's why we've developed some amazing survival techniques. For instance, deep in the jungles of South America, there's a bug. Well, technically, he's an arachnid, you see. And Shorty, I really hate when you do that. I really don't. I hate.
Oh, I'm sorry, Flick.
Where was I? Yes, Chilean tarantulas, like my friend Chili here, throw poison quills at their enemies with deadly accuracy.
I will miss.
This part's my favorite.
Paul! Come on, keep on coming! Ha ha, Chili's on a roll!
Hey! What are you guys trying to pull?
Watch it! Listen up, my aunt! Paul's still!
Back off! In case you hadn't noticed, why?
You missed! No one makes a fool of Chili, man! Come back here and die like a bug!
Alright, well, our next guest is a soldier termite who defends his mound by spraying intruders with acid. That's right, acid. Welcome him now, he's buff, he's ready, and he's buff. And he's ruining our set. You know, we have other shows to do.
I am a lean, mean, defensive machine. I am the Terminator.
You couldn't hide a flea!
Oh no? I detect more intruders.
No! They're not intruders! No! They're honorary bugs!
No. Intruders must be terminated. No exceptions. Oh, shoot. I need more ammo. I'll be back.
But, is everybody all right up there? Oh. I hope that none of you are allergic to acid. Oh, my. Best to move along. All right, our next guest. Let's meet the silent but deadly member of the bug world, the stink bug.
Target's ready, Flick.
All right. Oh, just a second. Let him in, Claire.
Hey! Fuck you, man!
Flick, what are these humans wearing on their heads?
Oh, I made the honorary bugs.
Honorary? What? They're our biggest enemy.
No, that's not true. They're my friends.
Friends? Get this loser out of my sight.
Hey!
Bring in the evidence. Friends don't exterminate. Friends do things. Still don't get it? Well then watch this. You humans have always seen madness as monsters. If you had it your way, you would destroy us all. But you never will, because we outnumber you 200 million to 1. Maybe it's time you honorary bugs got a taste of your own medicine. What? You're still alive? This means war! Hornets, arm your stingers and attack!
I'm going in for the sting!
Ouch! You are over your target, Black Widow Spider!
And cockroaches may exit safely. At this time, gather up your personal belongings and take your small grubs by.
got the pen.
Thank you.